नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज जेवियंस डॉक्टर नीरज धोलिया, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, गवर्नमेंट यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एंटीबायोटिक सेंसिटिविटी टेस्ट एंड अंडर द सब्जेक्ट मेडिकल बायोटेक्नोलॉजी। सो वॉट इज द एंटीबायोटिक सेंसिटिविटी टेस्ट? सो it is also known as the antibiotic sensitivity or antibiotic susceptibility test. So this is performed to know the susceptibility or the sensitivity of the bacteria towards the antibiotics. So generally some cases the bacteria get resistant to specific antibiotics, and that's why they do not showing the proper results which should be shown in the antibiotic treatments. So the susceptibility test or the sensitivity test is performed because the bacteria is resistant to some antibiotics, and the sensitivity testing results can allow a clinician to help him or her to prescribe the antibiotic which will give the better results. So when an antibiotic is selected based on the clinical suspicion about the site of the infection and common causative bacteria to directed therapy, in which the choice of antibiotic is based on knowledge of the organism and its sensitivity. Sensitivity testing is performed in the medical laboratories, in the pathology labs, and on the different culture using different culture methods. So in that culture methods, the bacteria are exposed to a variety or list of number of antibiotics, and it is checked that it is having the sensitivity towards which types of the antibiotics. If it is having the resistant to the specific type of the antibiotics, so for this we use the culture methods, and we use some paper discs which are absorbed with the specific antibiotics. So around the paper disc of the antibiotics, we found the zone. Some zone is there where the no bacterial growth is there. That is known as the zone of inhibition. So around paper disc containing antibiotics on agar culture dish that have been evenly inoculated with the bacteria, they found a zone of inhibition. Okay, so the for knowing the MIC, that is the minimum inhibitory concentration, the antibiotic sensitivity testing is performed, and the it can be estimated from the size of the zone of the inhibition. So the antibiotic susceptibility testing has occurred since the discovery of the antibiotic, that is penicillin, and it is a beta lactam antibiotic. So in the initial methods, the phenotypic characteristics are used to observe the sensitivity. Okay, so there is a strip of various antibiotics. It have the various antibiotics in it. So this is known as the e-test and antibiotic impregnated strip. And it has been available since 1980s. And along this, the genetic methods such as the PCR testing also performed since 2000. Research is going on into improving the current methods by making them faster or more accurate as well as developing the new methods for the testing of the antibiotics against the bacteria. So it is used in the clinical methods, in the clinical prescriptions. It is also used for the research purpose. Okay, so a simple, for example, a simple urinary tract infection might be treated with some standard antibiotics. Say, for example, is trimethoprim and the sulfamethoxazole. So in that cases, the antibiotic sensitivity test is not necessary. For the cases where standard antibiotics will work, it is not necessary. But in some cases, so for example, the E. coli is most likely causative the bacterium, and it may be sensitive to that the combination of antibiotics. Okay, so cases where the antibiotic resistance is developed, in that cases the antibiotic sensitivity test or assay is necessary. However, bacteria can be resistant to several classes of antibiotics. So this resistance might be because a type of bacteria has intrinsic resistance to some antibiotics, and because of the resistance following past exposure to the antibiotics, or because resistance may be transmitted from other source such as the plasmids. So what gives the resistance to the microbes or the bacteria? So a persistent stimulation with specific antibiotics makes the bacteria resistant. The mechanisms, the bacteria develops some mechanism that escape it from the antibiotics. Or it may be occurred by some specific plasmids. So the plasmids have the genes against the antibiotics. So it may be because of the plasmid. Antibiotic sensitivity testing provides information about which antibiotics are more useful and successful and should be prescribed to treat the infections. Okay. So various methods are there to perform the antibiotic testing. It may be performed in laboratory, it may be performed in the pathology labs or in the research. So one method is the phenotypic method, and second one is the genetic method. So in the genetic method, it is not very common. We check for the presence of some antibiotic resistant gene in the genome of the pathogen. So for that, the PCR is used. Okay, and in the phenotypic method, and this is very common method, testing based on the exposing bacteria to antibiotics, and it uses the culture plates like agar culture plates or broth you can use. So in that we have some selected antibiotics, then we prepare some antibiotic disc, and by dipping the papers on different antibiotics and with the known concentrations of the antibiotics. So to ensure that the results are accurate, the concentration of the bacteria that is added to the agar or broth must be standardized. So everything should be standardized, what concentration of antibiotics you are using, what concentration of bacteria you are using, what is the temperature, what is the incubation time, everything should be standardized to know the best results. So it can be accomplished by comparing the turbidity of the bacteria suspension. So you have to use each time the same concentration or same amount of the or same number of the bacteria. Okay, so the disc diffusion method involves selecting a strain of bacteria first and then placing it on the agar plates. Then we prepare a lawn of the bacteria. Then means the complete plate is covered with the grown bacterias. Then near the antibiotic, bacterias, after growing the bacterias, we prepare some wells, and in that either we can fill the antibiotic solution in the gaps, or we can use the antibiotic discs for performing the experiment. Okay, so if you are using the disc, antibiotic disc, it is known as the Kirby-Bohr method. Although there are other types of methods are also there, here a small paper disc containing the antibiotics are placed onto the plate upon which the bacteria are grown. Okay, so if antibiotics inhibits the microbial growth, we found a clear zone of inhibition and it is seen around the disc. Okay, so the bacteria are classified according to the diameter of the zone of inhibition: sensitive, intermediate, or resistant to an antibiotic by comparing the diameter of zone of inhibition to define thresholds. So you have a standard range, you have to compare that. Okay, then the Müller-Hinton agar is frequently used for the antibiotic susceptibility test, and various types of modifications are there. You can use the modifications also. So that was all about the antibiotic sensitivity test or antibiotic susceptibility test. Okay, so hope you are satisfied with this little session. If you have any doubt, any query, you can write in the comment box. This session is powered by Digital Version 2, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur. Thank you.